stupid feeling. It gives me great pleasure to introduce to you this evening Ray Wyatt on guitar, baby. Patrick O'Hearn on bass. Terry Bozio on drum. Eddie Jobson on keyboards. And the lovely Bianca on frostbite.
Until the dog was
She made up a plan so that she could get her rocks off. She figured the man wasn't going to do her any good. And she looked toward the dog for assistance. But she knew that a dog with hair evenly distributed all over its body was no good to anyone because it was stock. She wanted a customized dog, and that's where the poodle in its present condition originated. The woo man convinced the man to go out and get a job and to bring his money back to her. She took the money from the man and went out and got a pair of scissors, a pair of pliers, and a pair of zircon encrusted tweezers. You know what I'm talking about, don't you? Then she came back in. And the man, he was really tired from having his job and everything, so he went to sleep. Watched TV, drank a little beer, and the woo man started to work on the poodle. First she took his hat off, and she got out the scissors and she started clipping on it. She cleaned off his back here, like this, and around the medulla, on his thorax, in the T-zone. Cleaned him up here. Somewhere near Pawtucket, right in this area here. As a matter of fact, that is Pawtucket, isn't it? And then she cleaned and pruned and purified to a great degree the snout of the aforementioned dog. Cleaned them off around here so that you could see and feel and touch and piddle around with the succulent little black poodle lips. Easily visible to each and every one of you in this theater here tonight. And then she took the dog and she put the dog over in a corner like this. Took off her pants and went over and sat on his face. Somehow, I don't know how she managed to do it, but while she was down there with that poodle snout right up her, she managed to look deep into the poodle's eyes, and she said these words. Now listen here.
The poodle fight. 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 Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
is all clean and buzzing. Imagine all this man. Who are all those people that is locked away down there? Are they crazy?
Yeah.
We're just gonna drift away into another number. This is a more abstruse number. There's a gentleman that I did an interview with just before the program. We're gonna dedicate this song to him. This is definitely the kind of thing that he would enjoy. The name of this tune is Mars Needs Women. There was no moon inside. She knew the stars each shine, called the skies her time. Heard the scary wind, I seen the ugly trees. There was a werewolf honking long, silent me. I'm beating on bags, no, I ain't no sissy. I got a big titty girl in my name, Chrissy. Talking about her in my mind, me. And this ride up the mountain, a mystery, mystery. It was 11 o'clock upon a Friday night. You know the girl and me was feeling out of sight. We had 20 reds and a big old pile of weed. Drank some wine and then we LSD. There's a few twice a jar on my bike. She yelled, fire it up,
cause you know what I like.
Burn the lay on the tailpipe. Then she yelled, she again. I noticed even the crickets were acting weird up here, so I said, maybe I better drink a little beer. I said, give me some of that, what you're sucking on. But there was no reply because she was gone. Where's those titties I like so well? Goddamn beer is what I started to yell. And I heard this noise like a crunching twig. And up jumped the devil, who's about this big. He had a red suit on and a widow's peak. And then a pointed tail and like a sulfury. It was him all right, I swear I knowed it was. He had some human flesh stuffed underneath his claws. You know it looked to me like it was titty skin. I said, you son of a bitch, cause I was mad then. But he just got out the floss and started cleaning his fangs. So I shot him with my shooter, said, bang, bang, bang. The sucker just laughed and said, put it away, you know I ain't a whore. Now what you gonna say? You raise my prison?
Yeah, titties and all.
Well, what about my beer then?
Who the cat's this tall?
Even her. her boots?
Why would I lie to you?
Shit, you must have been hungry.
Yeah, this is true.
Well, don't they pay you good for the stuff you're supposed to do?
Well, you know, I can't complain when the checks come through.
I want my Chrissy. I want my beer.
You know?
You just puke back up, boy. Do you hear?
Mr. Man, blow it out your ass, motorcycle man. I mean, I am the devil. Do you understand? Just what will you give me for your titties and beer? I suppose you noticed this little contract here.
You're goddamn right, you are a son of a whore. That's about the only reason I learned Latin for. Give me that paper. Bet your ass I'll sign. Because I need a beer and it's titty squeezing time.
You can't fool me! You ain't that bad! You should have seen some of the soul I had. There were no eyes missing, and I knew too. And both of those suckers was worse than you.
Well, let's make a deal if you think that's true. I mean, you're the devil, so what you gonna do?
What I'm gonna do?
Yeah, what are you gonna do? You know, I always thought you were taller.
Wait, don't be bugging me about how short I am, man.
You know that thing on the end of your tail? It's really cute. What do you do with it?
Hey, man, I'm a shoulder, man.
You can have my soul. I don't care. You can have my soul. It's a mean little suck about 1,000 years old. Once you get it, you can't give it back. You gotta keep it forever. That's a natural fact. I want my beer. Give me that beer. And give me those titties. God damn it, give me those titties. I want those titties right now. Give me those titties. She gave us the finger, it was rigid and stiff. That's when the devil, he farted, and she went right over the cliff.
Oh, this is the best
lie
I've ever been on.
Wow, the devil was mad, I took off to my pad. I swear I do declare, I'll get you back there. I swear I do declare, I'll get you back there.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, wait a minute, let's get serious here. Just a minute, just get serious. Bianca, Frenchie, and you, the people of Carter, Rhode Island. my good buddies. Thanks, I needed that. As we're going to the concert, I hope that you enjoyed it. And goodbye. Before we start, I just want to tell you something, you know. I got an interesting feeling coming out on the stage in a shitty little theater with no heat in it, but, seriously now, folks, you know. I've never lived in a town like this, thank God. You don't shut the fuck up, I'm just going to play and I won't talk to you anymore tonight. Look here, I just want to say that when I can see you, when the lights go on, I can see the people out there, you know, just like, I could have gone to school with you people, you know, you look pretty familiar to me, even though I have the faintest idea of what it would be like to live in a place like this, but, it's like playing for a high school assembly or something. Anyway, in answer to this young girl's request here, this girl with a chest, and the buttocks, she wanted to hear a song called Dynamo Hum and Air Raid. Couldn't say where she's coming from, but this middle living in Dynamo Hum. Stroll on over there, look here, mama, got a $40 bill, says you can't make me come. No, no, you just can't do it. She made a bet with her sister, a little bit done, took a poop and a time off and was gone. I don't mind, she called me a bum, but I knew right away she was really gonna come. So I got down to it. Whipped off the plumbers and stiffened my thumb, and the fly road takes to a sugar plum. Two strokes of a wrist got numb. Still didn't hear no dynamo hum. No dynamo hum. Dynamo hum, dynamo hum. Bovine perspiration on her upper lip area, and she said, now listen to this, she said, just get me wasted and you're halfway there, as if my mind's tore up, then my body don't care. I rubbed my chinny chin chin and said, my, what sort of thing might this lady get high upon? The $40 bill didn't matter no more, when her sister got naked and laid on the floor, and she said, dynamo, mate. win the bet, but she could use a little if I wasn't done yet. I told her just because the sun got a place in the sky, no reason to assume I would give her a try. So I pulled on her hair, got her legs up in the air, and asked her if she had any cooties in there. Was buns up kneeling, I was wheeling and dealing. She surrendered to the feeling,
she
sweetly surrendered, smiling and squealing. I'm a watch from the edge of the bed, with her lips and just a twitching, her face going red, hands up to rolling down from the edge of the chin, watching my deep condition. Her sister was in, oh, she quivered and quaked and she clutched at herself, and her sister made a joke about her mental health until Dynamo finally did give in. But I told her all she really needed was some discipline. I said, kiss my aura, Dora. It's real and gorgeous. Would you all like some more right here on the floor? And how about you, Fauna? No. Do your walk. Wait a minute. Where's Fauna? Oh, Fauna, my dear. Fauna. I'm gonna tell you again tonight, all you gotta do is swallow it.
Oh, what? Yeah, you have it. You
get
my aura.
Aura. Don't you be playing the cousins with me. Meanwhile, couldn't say where she's coming from, but I just said a lady named Dynamo Hound. She stole all the roses and looked in the book. I got a $40 bill, so you can't bet the call. Oh, you just can't do it. But he only was a puppet. As a result of him stepping
all right.
If you needed stuff, they're at your disposal, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome, welcome to the party, and thank you for coming to the concert.
Thank you.
to the right place. This is it. And there's the cheesiest place in all of Pawtucket. How true indeed. Why don't they turn the heat on this fucking place? Yeah. So hot I could scream. Boy, you know, you and your girlfriend sound really far out and groovy. Ever been to a Holiday Inn? Just let me stroke the front part of my leotard. I will show you how a young girl such as you might be thrilled and overwhelmed by me.
But how
would
you
like to
say great thing?
The Lennox, would you like to spit right away? In the jungle while trying to keep a date with my little girl who was back in the States. Stranded in the jungle, free and alone, trying to figure a way to get a message back home. But how was I to know that the wreckage of my plane had been picked up and spotted my girl in lover's lane? Meanwhile, back in the States. Baby, baby, let's make a dance. You know you're old time lover. Thank you. Meanwhile, back in the jungle. The boys in the jungle had me on the run when something heavy hit me like an atomic bomb.
And my head started to clear. I had this strange feeling I was in cooking gear.
Boy, I turned around and I looked to see. That's when I found out there was a cooking bee.
Great! Let me out of here!
Meanwhile, back in the States. Meanwhile, back in the jungle. Never meant the worst. Oh yeah. Well, I jumped out the pot and I finally got away. Frantic with worry about what my baby said.
So I jumped into the ocean and started to swim, but my chances of survival were slim.
So I thumped down a whale who was in my way, and I reached the States in about a half a day.
When I went, I got the lover's lane. I was almost dead.
So it was gone, and here's what I said.
Baby, baby, that's no good. Oh, baby, baby, you should have understood.
You've been a red hot audience for a ridiculously cold beer. Thank you for keeping us warm tonight. And no, no more. We're gonna do it all over again in a minute. All right, if you want to see it again, come to the second show. Good night, Ray, Patrick, Terry. Bianca, Reggie.